Goedenavond Nederland and welcome to my YouTube channel. We have a representative of the Netherlands at Eurovision 2024 and it is Joost Klein. So, I must say, I'm freaking excited, even though I didn't know who was Joost Klein, even though I do live in this country for 4 years now. I only heard about him because he wanted to go on Eurovision. Not that he was chosen already for Eurovision, that he wanted to go on Eurovision and he made a huge campaign, you know, like advertising on TikTok and petitions, and you saw him in Dutch media that he wants to go, and he is actually going to Eurovision. So of course we don't know the song yet. It will be in January, I think, and I'm waiting. I have very high hopes. So Joost, please, graag, alsjeblieft. As we don't have the song, I'm gonna be reviewing other songs. So let's get familiar with Joost Klein music. I will check the 3 songs and we will listen to it, we will think about it and we will figure it out what can go to Eurovision and what cannot go to Eurovision. So yes, welcome to Klein, mein Klein world. Klein? Joost Klein. Droom groot. Okay, let's go. I think his most popular songs with like more than 100 million streams on Spotify is Friesenjung. So a young guy from Friesland. Is that this? And that's Joost Skiagu Otto Wolkes. I don't know who are these people. As I said, I didn't say that, I think, but that's not my music also. Like, and I feel and I hear a lot of Karia influence. Yeah. So, okay, let's see. Friesenjung. I'm a little Englishman in New York. Ooh! That's in German. Yeah, that's in German. What the hell? I've heard that song. No, I've heard that. I know what's that. No. Hey, I like it. I'm a little low. Yeah, he's from Friesland, I think. No, it's weird. It's so such a weird song. Yeah. Yeah. In Germany and Austria. Okay, Otto is from Germany and Austria. Okay, yeah. Oof. I don't know what to say. Like, it's fun. I love it. It's on my Spotify right now. Yeah, that kind of songs would not work on Eurovision. That's for sure. So no, Joost, yeah, don't go this way. It's a fun song though, but of course it's a cover of Englishman in New York, so it couldn't go on Eurovision. So when this song was 6 months ago, 2nd June, so yeah, he cannot just take this song to Eurovision. But I like it, it's fun, and he is something. I think he's gonna make a big show. So Dutch delegation, please, if you hear me, I really like to do interview met Joost. Ik spreek ook beetje Nederlands, so we can do it in Dutch, no problem. I will learn till then. But yeah, with Mia and Dion, they didn't do basically any interview during Eurovision, and I find it very sad actually, because when I ask like why the delegation say they want a peace and quiet, yeah, if you're going to Eurovision, you're not going for peace and quiet. You're going to, you want to have, make your name the most popular as it can be, because it's a huge competition and there's a lot of media, not only fan media, but especially televisions, you know. So that's the great, great step to be, you know, having more and more fans international. So yeah, I don't get it, but I hope with Joost it will be different. I think I'm gonna listen to Wachtmuziek. Yes. What is this? Okay. Okay. I don't know what's happening. It's going into your head right now. It's actually funny with his song, like it's the second song, but I can already hear that. It has a lot of Dutch influence, like from typical Dutch music, and I love it. I live for Dutch schlagers. I do live in Netherlands, if you don't know. I'm from Poland, I'm not Dutch, but I do live for Dutch schlagers. I love them. Yeah. But I don't hear him like singing much. I know he's a rapper, but I don't honestly know what can the song for Eurovision be. Like if they're gonna do something totally new, like keeping his style but making something more commercial, you know, like Karia, his song was one of the kind. I'm not a big fan of the song, honestly, and I really don't like the drama between jury votes, televotes. So because of that, I don't like the song till I don't listen to that, because it ruins my moment of happiness when Lauryn won. So I'm not a big fan of the song, like because of personal things, but I do appreciate the song, kind of, you know. So, but it was, yeah, I don't know. I'm so confused right now, you know, because what they gonna do? Okay, what's his another? Okay, so Friesenjung is the most popular one. Scandinavian boy, what the hell is this? Beaches. That's the song I want to listen. Jesus Christ. Oh, we have different style now. A bit. That was 6 years ago, 7 actually. Oh, whoa, whoa, it's falling. He's so young here. Okay. Okay, I know what his like strong point is the lyrics. Yeah, it's in rap. I had the same when I was reacting to Karia songs. I didn't understand it, of course, because I don't speak Finnish. But when I checked the lyrics, I was like, So here is exactly the same. Just the one difference that I can kind of understand it because I would not say I speak Dutch, but I understand Dutch, you know, and I can speak a bit. So yeah, but I don't like this, honestly. I don't like bitches, no. Recent Wachtmuziek we have. Friesenjung. Ome Robert has 16 millions, and that's the second most listened song. Ome Robert. Okay, that will be the last song. And my confusion is still there. Like, what they gonna show us? I have no idea. Oh, that's a bit. What? Oh God. Guys, what is happening here? This is weird. And I like the beat though. I like the beat. But I'm not gonna put this song again. It's creepy with the clown. Okay, last one. Joost, Florida 2009. I think that's the one of the his recent one. Ooh. Oh, that's okay. We see him in Friesland. Crematie van je pa. Nooit meer samen kijken naar DWDD. Nooit meer dansen in het huis. En nooit meer klappen met een vuist. Wellicht was het niet juist. Maar ik mis ons. En ik mis thuis. Oh!
Daar sta je dan, bij de crematie van je ma. Veel huilende.
Wow, that's something totally different now.
En ze was zo'n lieve vrouw. Nog zoveel dat ik zeggen wou. Van, het spijt me en sorry, maar mijn hart die is nu koud. Voor jou bewaar ik mijn geduld. In een kistje onder mijn bed.
Oké. Okay.
Maar wat is
het? Actually emotional.
Zonder pret. Florida, 2009. Daar kwwam ik mezelf tegen. Maar heb een steen verlegd in de rivier.
Am I listening to the same artist or? Yeah, it's Joost Klein, Drum Groot. Aww. No, it was a very emotional song, but I felt like I went to totally different artist now. You know, it's actually quite interesting. If he could like combine the emotionality from this song, maybe not that much because it says about pretty hard topic, and the beats and his personality like all together, then I think it's masterpiece. Okay, to sum up everything what I've said and the mixed emotions in my head, I think it is a great choice for the Netherlands. It is very brave choice and I'm really... Oh. No, but really, I think it's a very brave choice and congratulations. I think after many years of safe songs, of good songs, of course, it's not that they are bad. Like Burning Daylight was also a good song. That's something different. And it is totally love or hate. Like the same with Karia and Cha-Cha-Cha. the people will love it or they hate it. Nobody will like go next to that without any emotion or any thought. So my Dutch heart will support it 100%. I'm generally a very patriotic person, you know, towards Poland and towards Netherlands. Doesn't matter what kind of songs they are like participating. I will support these two countries because my heart is in these two countries. And this is what I love about Eurovision also. Some people are like, oh, doesn't matter. You like the song only because it's from Poland, because it's from Netherlands. Well, yes, of course. I can like it. I don't need to like it, but I will support it because my heart belongs in these two countries, between these two countries. So in Germany, actually. But yeah, and I'm expecting something with a bang, but something more commercial than what we've heard like before. A little bit more commercial. I don't mean that he has to do pop now. I hope he will not try to sing, because he said he cannot sing. So I don't want to hear bad vocals as Karia last year. With all my respect to Karia, I don't know still why he did that. What was the purpose of proving everybody, I can sing, I can sing? No, bro, you cannot sing. Sing can Loreen or Alika of Alessandra, but not you, Karia. So I hope Joost will be also not singing. He will focus on the same thing as... he will focus on the thing he can do. So we also are not asking pop singers to sing opera and opera singers to rap. So do what you are good at and not try to change yourself. Because for me, like comparing to cha-cha-cha, I like the beginning, I like the middle, I hate the ending. Like for me, it was not... I don't know, I couldn't listen to that. It was false. The rainbow, no, that was not my thing. Sorry, maybe you will hate me, but yeah. So I hope they will learn the lesson, like from Karia performance. And I hope maybe he will do something different, although he looks a bit like him even. So I think we put it into the box already with the same box as Karia, but who cares? I think we have more careers this year, actually, because it's the same like with last year. We had Chanel, 2 years ago we had Chanel, and this year at Eurovision we have a lot of dance breaks. So I think it's the same case here. And from Netherlands, I'm expecting a lot. I'm expecting Big Bob with great rap, with great beat, with great personality and great stagings. Let me know what do you think about Joost Klein. I would love to read your comments, and I see you in the next video. Bye!